I decided to add a little something extra to my Kappa code window for a quick visual interpretation of my Kappa value, and this is based on the feedback I had gotten from Philip. So I'm going to show you the couple things that I did and how easy it is to add this. So here's my original output over here. And if I double click, you can see my scripting here. I kept all the scripting exactly the same and I added one extra comment. Basically, I put in an if statement that's going to change the color of my button if I meet a specific threshold for Kappa. And that threshold needs to be decided by you as the researcher. There's no one correct answer for this. But if you remember looking at this interpretation table that I had, substantial agreement begins at about 0.6, 0.61. So I just picked 0.6 for this particular example. You can decide whatever that value needs to be. So I said here, if, and the first section in the parentheses here is the condition, if a condition is met. So if Kappa, which is my variable from up here, is greater than 0.6, then I'm going to have it, the next comma set here tells me what I want it to do when that condition is met. So it said button color, and this is the way that Studio Code uses button colors. They do the three number, the red, green, blue way. So if you're not sure, there are a couple of like how to say what color you want. There are a couple of options for you. If you hit, let me just click on a specific spot here. I'll have it inserted here. If you click insert example script and you scroll down, they have some automatic like basic colors in here that, so if I clicked blue, it's gonna give me, I gotta scroll down. It's gonna, this right at the end here, this means 100% blue. It's not necessarily the blue that you want, but it's one particular blue. So that is one option. You can pick one of their colors, which is what I did here. A pure form of green is what I had it turn into. Your other option is that every Mac comes with something called the digital color meter. And I have this open right here. And you can find that by using your search table. If you just start typing in the word color or digital color meter, it should just pop up. It's automatically in your like utility on your Mac. So what this digital color meter does is if you find a color that you like, so for example, if I wanted it to turn into like the color blue of this folder here, when I point to something on my Mac, you can see, look right over here at these numbers. So when I point to that object, it gives me those three numbers, 54, 66, 72. That's what it's gonna take to make the color that's in that particular pixel. If I wanted this yellow color, it would be 99, 182. So that's what you would fill in the scripting. So whatever these three numbers are, you can actually figure out an exact color you want by using the digital color meter that's already on your computer. So that's just kind of a little sidetrack, but something interesting that you may not even use it for an if statement. You may be just, or not for Kappa, but you might use it for something else. So going back to this, in an if statement, there are three parts. You're basically giving, you say, if it meets this condition, do this. So I'm saying turn it into a green color. And then if you choose to have like the not, like if that statement is false, you can add another comma and add this. And this time I have, if not, basically change the button color. This is an orange color here. I just picked some very simple colors. So basically what this is going to do is just check my Kappa value and change the color of this box. The other thing I added was this extra box here. You can see I've added another script. I basically just duplicated this script and went in and edited how it looked. So I kept all the same scripting in here and I got rid of my show Kappa because instead I want it to actually show whether or not I made a substantial agreement. So I did another if statement for this one. And it says, if Kappa is greater than 0.6, show, and then in quotes, I wrote substantial agreement. So the word substantial agreement will show up in this box as the output if Kappa is greater than 0.6. And then for my false statement, I said, show the words less than substantial agreement if we didn't meet that condition. So now I've shown this in multiple ways. You can actually see my Kappa value, the box will change color, and either the word substantial agreement or less than substantial agreement will pop up for this once I code something. Notice a couple changes that I made to this box. So I got rid of the button name. I got rid of the identifier, which is that yellow square that pops up. So when I got rid of that, I gotta get back in here. I don't want the identifier in there. I don't know why it's not going away now. Oh, because that's the identifier for the one behind it. So I got rid of the identifier. I made the text wrap so it stays in here. And what I did was I changed the background color to non-existent, so it's just kind of clear and it would go straight through. It's kind of part of the other button now. Those are all some aesthetics that you can change later. So I want to show you how this might change if I change my code window. I made this example at this value because I can just change one, just one of the agreements on here, and it's actually going to change my kappa. So let me see if I can find a good way of showing this to you. So right now you see it's I've got my kappa value, it's green, and it says substantial agreement. But now if I go back here, and let's say Raider 1 didn't say mild. Let's say for this particular case, Raider 1 said moderate. Now that's going to change automatically when I go back to my code window. Now it turned orange. It says less than substantial agreement because my kappa calculation is now below 0.6. But if you, as you see, if you had combined a lot of code windows, it's a really quick visual way to see it right away.